Hello, my name is Deborah Moretti. I am a postdoc at the University of Bonn in the group of Professor Stephanie Bruggen in the Technology Innovation Management group. And I'm here to present our preliminary results of our project in collaboration with the group of Professor Hubert Finger in the ETH Zurich. And our project is called Adoption of Precision Agriculture Technologies, and we use a different methodology to deepen the knowledge and understanding of the different stakeholder perceptions that are involved in the adoption of such technologies. So the motivation that drives our study is the low adoption, the recurrent low adoption of such technologies, specifically the technologies that deal with intensive data collection, with different technologies such as sensors, smart sensors, and IoT. Those technologies, despite they are in the market for many years, their rate of adoption in European fields is still lower than expected. And possible explanations that are in the literature mostly regard to single source perceptions, mostly regarding the farmer alone. They present unidimensional results without considering the perceptions of other stakeholders, and therefore they give limited attention to value propositions, so focus more in the efficiency of the technology, for example, or usefulness, but give limited attention to the value proposition of the technology or the group of technologies, and therefore also give limited attention to a systemic perspective. We bring here our view regarding the innovation system, so we base our arguments in the technology innovation system, and possibly regarding the legitimacy of these technologies. We understand that the legitimacy of these technologies maybe are still under construction, and to better develop this concept, we need to find a more shared view among the relevant actors. So first, to improve the flow of information and increase social acceptance, and therefore avoid illegitimacy, a shared vision among the relevant actors is needed, and is exactly how we give the approach for this project. So the research question that guides this project is, how do farmers perceive challenges and opportunities of precision agriculture technologies? And most importantly, how might these perceptions differ from other prominent stakeholders of the TIS? So how these different opinions get together so as we can build a shared vision, or how different they are, and therefore how they influence, this difference influence the adoption of these technologies. We approach this research, we try to answer this research question with the group concept mapping methodology, as it is a bottom-up approach. It joins the different perceptions of the different stakeholders, provide, and then with the results, we can provide a joint opinion. We can see how we can build a joint opinion, and also gives equal voice to the different stakeholders. So it's a possibility to equalize the voice of these different stakeholders that sometimes are lower than others. And one most interesting result from this methodology that is that we identify go zones for action, so we can really bring some practical results to put on the table. So the GCM, the group concept mapping, regards to three main steps, which are the brainstorming group, the sorting and rating phase, and then the construction of the visual maps, decisions should be taken, and analysis of the results. What happens is that in this methodology, we begin with a brainstorming group. In our case, we had 80 participants discussing for around 2 hours in April 2019. And from this discussion, we generated some statements. So we generated 58 statements from the discussion of these stakeholders. And this discussion is guided by a focus prompt. What I mean is a sentence that should be completed by the participants. So the sentence that we proposed was drivers or a driver of the adoption and diffusion of precision technologies are or is. The participants should complete this sentence in order to begin the discussion. From this discussion, as I said, we got 58 statements, and those statements should be sorted and rated by a second group of participants. So we had 76 participants, both from Germany and Switzerland, and several different stakeholders also in this group. Important to say is that in the brainstorming group, we also had a very heterogeneous group. So we had different stakeholders that comprise this group. For example, universities, farmers, companies, and agricultural chamber. This also happened in the second group. So in the second group, we have different stakeholders that sorted and rated those statements. And we are now analyzing this map. We are creating these visual maps and analyzing them. And we are showing here our preliminary results. As I said, the data collection for the sorting and rating for the second phase took place from October 2019 to July 2020, regarding this focus prompt I told you. And here we see, in this slide, we see in the left side, three examples of statements that we got. For example, one driver for adoption and diffusion of precision farming technologies is the superiority of just-in-time measurements. Or drivers are the requirements of the trade, or is the improvement of labor productivity. So we had 58 from those, and the participants sorted them into different categories, which were labeled as they wanted. So the number of clusters or number of clusters and the label of those clusters is decided by the participant. And then a second test would be to rate those statements alone according to importance or influenceability of this statement. What I mean is how easy is for stakeholders, different stakeholders, to influence what is being said by these statements, to influence what must occur. Those participants, they also answered some demographic questions. So they put themselves as the stakeholder, so they chose which type of stakeholder they were. This was not defined by us, but by the participant. And they also answered regarding age, educational background, and we can see here that they had educational background that relates to the field, for example, agriculture training or economics, environmental sciences, for example. The number of participants from Switzerland and Germany are kind of the same, so they are groups that we can combine if necessary. And also we had we defined main four stakeholder groups, which are farmers, intermediaries, which we called as consultancies, agricultural chambers, for example, the companies, mainly technology developers, and policymakers. So the first graph that we provide is the cluster map. So each yellow point in the graph you see is one statement, and they are put on the map by the software. A software is called the Global Max software. And in this graph, you can see eight clusters, eight different clusters, which comprise these 58 statements. And we see that the clusters have different they are different categories. For example, training and consultancy from training and consultancy to data protection or profitability, which is, for example, one of the most named preoccupations when adopting precision agriculture technologies, to sustain the profitability of the farmer and also to improve this profitability, right? We can take this map and also provide the rating map. So all the clusters that we saw in the previous slide now are represented regarding how the participants rated them regarding the dimensions. So here we see the importance. So the most, the higher the number of layers that a cluster has, the higher is the rating of importance. So it's very interesting to see that protection of resources, for example, in the upper right of this slide, is one of the most highly rated clusters that we have. In the other side, profitability was not rated of that importance. It's there, it's a driver, but was not rated as so important. We are seeing here the maps of all the participants together, yes? And this is second graph, shows the influenceability. So all again, protection of resources was rated as highly influenceable from the stakeholders. And one interesting graph that we can also generate is the go zones, as I said in the beginning. And what we are seeing here is not anymore the clusters, the statements combining the clusters, but the statements alone. And in the green zone, for example, the green zone represents the statements that were highly rated for importance and also highly rated for influenceability. So it represents the green zone, the gold zone for action that probably could shape a shared vision as proposed in the beginning. And as we could expect, one of the most highly rated statement, number 25, is exactly related to the protection of resources, as we saw on the cluster analysis. So, for example, here this statement says that one driver is the opportunity to work in a more environmentally friendly way. One statement as example that was not highly rated, neither for importance nor for influenceability, is the difficult drivers could be the difficult geographical locations such as hillside locations, but most of the farmers or the stakeholders probably do not come from those areas, so they do not rate this as so important or also so influenceable by the technology. And what we wanted at the beginning was to compare the different stakeholders, right? So to see how different is their perception regarding those statements and clusters. So in the left side, we see a comparison from Switzerland and Germany to understand how different our two populations were. And actually, we see that there are some differences in the opinions, for example, of course, but those differences are not so prominent as the difference between two stakeholder groups. So in the right side of this slide, in the right side graph, we see the comparison from policymakers and farmers, and those differences are much more prominent as we see from the area of the graph. So it's interesting to see that possibly these different perceptions are really there on the field, and maybe this is influencing the rate of adoption and diffusion of such technologies. So as a preliminary remarks, we can say that we could really assess the perceptions from this multi-stakeholder group regarding the drivers for adoption and diffusion of pets. We could identify different clusters, different categories that relate to this to these perceptions, ranging from education and collaboration to the application and investment challenges. We could see that the difference between the two populations, the two countries, are not so expressive, which would actually support the robustness of our data. But the difference between the stakeholder groups would really sign a lack of agreement between the stakeholders, and that the drivers that relate to resource savings and protection seem to be a general concern. So it's possible that this shared visual that you're proposing here could be shaped through the awareness of the environmental crisis and awareness of our need and necessity to protect environmental resources. So thank you very much for your attention. As I said, those are preliminary results, so your feedback is very important, and I hope you have questions and comments regarding these results and our approach, our theoretical approach to the problem. Thank you.